हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो आई वॉज टीचिंग यू द रैट ट्रैप सेलर. आई टोल्ड यू दैट रैट ट्रैप सेलर ही गॉट शेल्टर इन द क्रॉफ्टर हाउस एट नाइट. ही वॉज वेरी हैप्पी विद दिस टाइप ऑफ हॉस्पिटलिटी बिकॉज नोबडी इंटरटेन हिम टिल नाउ. नोबडी यूज टू लेट हिम एंटर इन टू द हाउस. So he was entertained. He was not only entertained, he was offered food. He was the crofter told him to play the card and he was very happy. They played the card till late at night, and after that they slept because already it was late at night. Now children, the crofter, he woke early in the morning because he had to milk his cow. And at the same time, when he got up, the rat trap seller also got up from the bed, and he thought it would be better if he will get up from, because the master of the house had got up from the sleep, so it would not look nice if he will also take a nap or sleep for a long hours. So he also got up, and both of them went out of the house. The crofter of the house, he went to milk his cow, who is to give milk for the creamery, and he went ahead. After half an hour, he returned back. The rat trap seller returned back, and he stole 30 the money which he got it by selling the milk of the cows. Okay, so the croft, he took all the money from his bag and he went ahead in the forest, thinking that if he will go to the forest, he will not have the fear that the sheriff will come and catch him. So he went. Children, when he was walking to the forest to go from to the other side of the forest, he realized he had been walking around in the same part of the forest. And at once he recalled his thought about the word that the rat trap. Now his own turn had come. Till now he was laughing on other, and now he is thinking that money which he had stolen is like a bait of the rat to him, and the whole forest he is comparing to the rat trap. And he himself is like a rat, and he also thinks that he is fooled by a bat and had been caught in the rat trap. The whole forest is like an impenetrable prison from which he could never escape. Now impenetrable here means the prison where the person cannot come out. He cannot penetrate means to go inside. Now he went inside the forest and he thought that now he would never come out from that forest. He cannot escape. He can never get out of from that forest. 30 not a bait for him which took him to the forest. That was the rat trap to him. He was so tired that he fell on the ground, and finally he heard thumping sound and he was happy that some people are around. This sound gave him some hope also, and he staggered towards the place from where the sound was coming. Well, he walked and walked, and finally he reached to the place where children, that crofter from where he had stolen the money, even he worked there as a crofter. Crofter is a farmer. He reached to the mill. There was a lot of sound around it, especially the sound of nature, the sound of waterfall, and as well as the sound coming from the iron mill. Now he went inside the mill. Iron master looked casually and at the intruder. Now, who is the intruder here? What do you mean by intruder? Intruder means the person who comes uninvited. And he just simply looked at the intruder because he was used to such type of stranger. Intruder at the mills who used to take shelter there every night. So he knew that such type of person, they come and take the shelter. So it was not a new thing for him. That's why he did not ask, he did not care for him. And he's so similar to the other intruder, like he was putting a rough clothes, shabby looking. He was looking very shabby. So he was not paid any attention by anybody at that place. Now the rat trap asked his permission to give shelter there. And children, he, without saying anything, without welcoming him, he just nodded his head to give his consent that he could stay there at night. So without saying anything, that Iron Master, he gave him permission. He simply nodded his head and he gave permission to sleep there at night. Now children, he got a shelter, he was tired, and he started sleeping. He covered his face with a hat. And he started sleeping. Now let's see what happened. We were here. It was late in December. Darkness was already descending over the forest. I think this I've read. Okay. Now, I think I've done this page with you. Now, I was here in page number 36. So, the black eye, yes, I was telling, when he asked permission from the blacksmith, okay, he glanced at him and he told him he could stay there. And he looked the way people of his type usually did, because with a long beard, dirty, ragged, and with a bunch of rat traps dangling on his chest, he thought that this type of people comes at night and take shelter there. So he did not tell him to get away. It was a very common thing there. He asked permission to stay, and the master blacksmith nodded haughty constant without honoring him with a single word. That means he did not even welcome him. He did not ask his name. He did not ask from which place he belonged. He simply nodded his head and he gave his consent to stay there in the mill. The tramp did not say anything either. He had not come there to talk, but only to warm himself and sleep. Now, even the rat traps later, he did not say anything. He did not talk much because he came there for rest. So he did not talk to him, and even he slept. In those days, the Ramsjoe Iron Mill was owned by a very prominent iron master, whose greatest ambition was to ship out good iron to the market. Now children, the writer is talking about that famous mill, the Ramsjoe's Iron Mill, and it was very famous. Now the master of that mill, of that iron mill, he gave permission. He was a bit careful. He never used to give permission to everyone. So in those days, the Ramsjoe's Iron Mill was owned by a very prominent iron master, whose greatest ambition was to ship out good iron to the market. Now children, his ambition, the master of that mill, he had only one ambition. And what was his ambition? To ship out good iron to the market. He wanted to export all the good iron to the market. He watched both night and day to see that the work was done as well as possible. Now children, whole day and night he was used to come and watch that the everything is going smoothly in the mill. Everybody was working in the mill because he wanted to do his job properly. He wanted to sell the best iron from his mill. So he watched both night and day to see that the work was done as well as possible. And at this very, when he came there, at this very moment, when he came into the forge on one of his nightly round of inspection. Now children, sometimes he used to come
for the inspection at night also. And unfortunately, when this rat trap seller was there, that day also he came for the inspection. Naturally, the first thing he saw was a tall ragamuffin who had eased his way so close to the furnace that steam rose from his wet rags. Now, ragamuffin means a person who wears dirty and torn clothes. Now, children, as soon as he entered inside the mill, what he saw, that a tall ragamuffin. Ragamuffin means the person who looks shabby and he puts dirty and torn clothes, and who was sleeping close to the furnace. And children, it was a winter time, so due to moisture his clothes was wet, and since he was there sleeping close to the furnace, the steam rose from his wet rags. So the steam was coming out from his wet rags. He did not have quilt, he was simply lying on the floor near the furnace, so the steam was coming out from his cloth, which was wet due to the fog and the mist which was falling during the time of winter season. It usually falls in winter season. The iron master did not follow the example of the blacksmith. Now, children, this iron master was just opposite. He was in contrary with the blacksmith. Blacksmith allowed him. He did not even ask that from which place he belonged. He did not even ask his name, and he allowed him to stay there. He could stay there for the whole night, and in the morning he can move. But the other fellow, okay, who is the master of this Ramjo's iron mill, he was a bit careful, and he was just opposite of that blacksmith. The iron master did not follow the example of the blacksmith, who had hardly deigned to look at the stranger. So, deign means it was his blacksmith. He thought what will happen if he will allow him. He was a bit careless type of fellow. So, here Dan means that he was a bit careless, okay, due to his due to him only he was staying there in the mill. So, but the iron master, he was something different. His nature was something different. He looked at the stranger, he walked close up to him, looked him over very carefully. Now, children, since he saw that man for the first time, so he walked to him, and he very carefully he started looking and thinking that who that person might be. For the first time he was seeing him, so he walked close to him, looked him over very carefully, then tore off his slouch hat to get a better view of his face. Now, slouch hat means a hat with a broad brim, a hat which is having a broad brim, so that while sleeping he put his hat on his face, okay, so he could sleep peacefully, the light will not disturb him. So he pulled that hat away from his face. "But of course it is you, Nils Olof," he said. "How do you look?" Now, children, when he saw his face, he started remembering that one commanding officer used to work with him in the army, and he is the same officer. Now, what was his name? Nils Olof. So he told him, "Oh, of course it is you, Nils Olof," he said. "How do you look?" And he said, "How shabby you are looking, how you are looking now. You used to be such a smartly dressed at that time, and you were such a wonderful officer, and now your look has changed." The man with the rat traps had never before seen the iron master at Ramjo's and did not even know what his name was. Now, this man who was a rat trap seller, he was surprised to see that man, that Ramjo's iron master was greeting to him like that, because he had not seen him, even he had not known that person. But it occurred to him that if the fine gentleman thought it was an old acquaintance means a person whom he knew. So he thought, if he is thinking that his Nils Olof, let him think. It would be good for him. He might perhaps throw him a couple of kroner, and maybe he will help him with the money. Therefore, he did not want to undeceive him all at once. Yes, God knows things have gone downhill with me, he said. He did not even once told him that he is not the person to whom you are thinking. As a Nils Olof, he only told the answer in some other way. Okay, he told, yes, God knows things have gone downhill with me. You should not have resigned from the regiment. Now, children, that Iron Man's master, thinking that he is his old comrade, Nils Olof, now he is talking that you should not have resigned from that regiment. Okay. That was your mistake. If only I had still been in the service at the time, it never would have happened. He told ki, unfortunately, even I left the service before you. And if I would have been in the service at that time, I would have never allowed you to take this resignation. Well, now, of course, you will come home with him. Now, anyway, he told you, just come. He invited to his house. He told him to come his home with me, to go along up to the manor house and be received by the honor like an old regimental comrade. That, however, did not please the tramp. Now, children, once again he thought ki, if he will go to his manor house is a very large and beautiful house, and he told ki, and be received by the honor like an old regimental comrade, that however did not please the tramp. Now he thought ki, he will go to such a big house and everybody will treat him as if he is Nils Olof, so that when he will come to know that he is not that person, he might hand him over to the police. So he thought that why he is calling me. Okay, and this thing, he knew that he has mistook him for his friend, but at the same time he told he did not think right to go to his house. So what he did, the iron master followed him. So the iron mill master did not follow what the blacksmith had done, and instead he had invited. At first he was curious to know that who was he, but when he saw him, when he went to see the man from whose clothes the steam were coming, and when he removed his hat, he thought that it is his old friend Nils Olof. He mistook the man for his old acquaintance Meslev, that means the person to whom you know very much, the person who is near and dear to you. He thinks that he is his old comrade. The rat trap seller was not very amazed, as he knew that he is not Nils Olof. Now he was not very happy when he told that he is a Nils Olof. He did not, even the rat trap seller was not happy. He did not wanted to take help from the iron master. He agrees to the iron master that he is Nils Olof now, but he thought, but if he will tell him the right thing, he might hand him over to the police. So it's better not to open his house. Now what he tell, he admits that he is Nils Olof, and God knows that the thing had gone down with him. He accept that he knew him. He told the iron master that earlier he was not like that, but nowadays he is looking like that. Now, children, he also did not give the picture that he is not Nils Olof. In fact, he had talked to him in such a way that even the person, he started believing that he is his friend Nils Olof. So from their talk, it seems that they were together when they were in army, and they used to work and knew each other there. Now, page number 37. No, I could not think of it. He is thinking quite army, not to go up to the manor house would be like throw himself voluntarily into the
Ions then, but children, at the same time he was thinking of that 30 kroner which he had stolen from that crofter house. He told ki if I will go with this kroner in that house, and suppose if by chance he knew about him, then he will be, what he will do, he will just call the police and he will hand me over to the police. He thought of the 30 kroner to go up to the manor house would be like throwing himself voluntarily into the lion's den. He thought that he would be, if he will go, it would be like going straight away to the lion's den. He only wanted a chance to sleep here in the forge and then sneak away as inconspicuously as possible. Now children, he started thinking that he would be in danger if he will go there. So he is telling it's better to sleep here only, and without, no, everybody will forget about him. Inconspicuously means without being discernible, and nobody will notice him in the morning. He will just move from here. So this was his plan. The ironmaster assumed that he felt embarrassed because of his miserable clothing. Now children, here he is thinking that he should stay the whole night, he should stay here, and the morning he should skip, he would skip from that place, and in this way he would save himself. But the ironmaster, he is thinking something else. He is thinking because of his ragged clothes and his long beard and his, because of his shabby appearance, he is hesitating to come to his house. So he thinks this. The iron master assumed that he felt embarrassed. The iron master is thinking that he is embarrassed by his shabby clothes to enter in the house. So he made him comfortable. He told him, please don't think that I have such a fine home that you cannot show yourself there, he said. He told ki, see, if you are feeling that, if you are scared of something that you are not coming to the house, so don't think like that. My house is not such a fine house that it cannot entertain you, he said. Elizabeth is dead, he told ki, my wife is dead. As you may have already have heard, he told ki, you must have heard about my wife, she already died. And my boys are abroad, and he told ki, my sons, they are not here with them, believing with me, they are abroad. And there is no one at home except my oldest daughter. Now he told ki, in my home only my oldest daughter is there and myself. We were just saying that it was too bad we did not have any company for Christmas. And he think there, my daughter will also love to have you, because we did not have anyone for our company for this Christmas. No guest had come this time for in our house for Christmas. So my daughter, she would be happy to have you there. Now come along with me and help us make the Christmas food disappear a little faster. Now children, definitely the Christians, they celebrate Christmas in a very nice manner. They prepare something very special. So he told that my daughter must have prepared some very special food. Now you just come and had those food as quickly as possible, so the food should disappear faster. But the stranger said no and no and again no, and the iron master saw that he must give in. Now children, again and again he was inviting him, and again he was saying no. Then finally iron master left the place. He thought that he is feeling shy, that's why he is not coming. So he thought ki he must send his daughter to invite him. It looked as though Captain Von Staley preferred to stay with you tonight, Sir Storm, he said to the master blacksmith, and turned out on his heel. Naturally he turned to master blacksmith, who gave his permission to stay there at night. He told him, it looked as though Captain Von Staley preferred to stay with you tonight. He told ki my friend Captain Von Staley, he did not want to come with me. I think he want to stay with you tonight. And he turned on his heel. But he laughed to himself as he went away. And the blacksmith who knew him understood very well that he had not said his last word. Now, blacksmith, he knew very well about his habit. He knew that something else was in his mind which he did not said to us. He told most of the things which he should have told at that time. But the last word he did not take out from his house, from his mouth. But blacksmith knew his nature, so he started laughing. It was not more than half an hour before they heard the sound of a carriage. He knew what he wanted to say. Actually, the work which he was not able to do, his daughter used to do it. That word he could not tell there. But the blacksmith knew his habit, so he started laughing. And children, what blacksmith had thought, it had happened. After half an hour, he heard the sound of the carriage wheels outside the forge, and a new guest came in. But this time it was not the iron master. He had sent his daughter, apparently hoping that she would have better powers of persuasion than he himself. And children, as he had guessed, it was the daughter of that iron master who had come to take him. He knew that if he cannot do anything, he sent his daughter to do that thing. And she had a better power of persuasion than he himself. Persuasion means to insist somebody. Okay. So she knew that she has a better power of persuasion. She will insist him. And definitely she will be the winner. She will take him to his house. Manor house. Manor house is the house of the landlord. Okay. So this was the plan. And now the daughter comes. Now let's see what happened. She entered followed by a valet. Now she entered there. Okay, the daughter also came inside there. And she was followed by a valet. Valet means a personal attendant. So a servant was there who also accompanied her, carrying on his arm a big fur coat. Now her father must have told her that he is feeling embarrassed because maybe his dress is very shabby, it is worn out, it is torn. So she was carrying a beautiful fur coat in her hand to give him. She was not at all pretty, but seemed modest and quite shy. Now that girl was not very beautiful, but she seemed modest, and she was her nature was looking as if she is feeling shy. In the forge, everything was just as it had been earlier in the evening. Now children, nothing, the work was going on, the same work was carried out till now. Okay, nothing new was going on. The master blacksmith and his apprentice still sat on their bench, and iron and charcoal still glowed on the furnace. That means whatever work was happening there, it happened. The stranger stretched himself out on the floor and lay with a piece of pig iron under his head and his head pulled down over his eyes. Now, the stranger to whom they thought it is their comrade, it is their friend, Nils Aloof, he was still sleeping on the floor, stretched his body, and he took one of the iron ore and used it as if it is a pillow, and his still face was covered with that hat. As soon as the young girl caught sight of him, she went up and lifted his hat. Now that young girl, like her father, she also came to him and she lifted her hat. The man was evidently used to sleeping with one eye open. Now, children, he was in a habit. It was his habit that while sleeping, his one eye was partially opened. He jumped up abruptly and seemed to be quite frightened. When he saw that a girl is taking his hat, he was so scared at what happened this time. He jumped up abruptly means suddenly, and seemed to be quite frightened. but she made him comfortable. She told him, "My name is Adela William Manson," said the young girl. "My father came home and said that you wanted to sleep here in the forest tonight. And then I asked permission to come and bring you home to us. I'm so sorry, Captain, that you're having such a hard time." Now she gave her introduction. She told ki I'm the daughter of the Iron Master and my name is Adela Will Manson. Said that girl was quite young, and he told ki just now my father came home and he told about you. You wanted to sleep here in the forest tonight, and he also told me that you wanted to sleep here in the forest only. And then I asked permission to come and bring you home to us. But she told ki you are my father's. You used to be one of my best friend of my father. You used to be his comrade. So I don't want you that you should pass your time here. I'm so sorry, Captain, that you're having such a hard time. At the same time, she told him that she is feeling sorry for the captain that he is having such a hard time. So, children, with this, I stop here. And please go through it. Please see, because this is a very here a turning point is there in the life of that rat trapper. So with this, I end my video here. Bye bye.